What's this? Guards, what is this prisoner doing here?
Your Honor, I beg your pardon. She must have slipped her watchman. You! Who let you out of your cell? Come along. You'll be tried when you're called.
The Magister flushes with indignation. He lays a hand upon his sword.
It's for their own good. It's for the good of us all. If you can't understand that...
Let's not be hasty, Magister. This ought to be an education for all of us. Tell me, Sorcerer, what did you hope to gain by interrupting these proceedings?
Sister, do not stay here. You must run. Run!
The only travesty is that anyone could be unwilling to sacrifice what must be sacrificed. All that you give up, you give back to the realm. It's very simple, and very selfish to refuse. How to explain it? You see, with this wand, I can leech the source from within you. You'll no longer attract Voidwoken. Rivalon need no longer fear you. All this talk, why don't I just show you? Madam, please do hold still.
No! Animal, beast, slug, please, no!
Perfection. I imagine it's quite hard for you to fathom. I don't suppose I'd look forward to this fate myself, but you must understand, if your kind are left well enough alone, the Voidwoken will destroy us. All of us. This elf has sacrificed her source. Some might say the spark of life within her. But she has done so in the name of us all. She is a hero. I would have loved for you to have seen our point, my friend. It would have made your transformation all the more rewarding for both of us. But the Divine Order doesn't need you to understand. It only needs you to accept. Now it's your turn to repent, my friend. I'm so glad you joined us here today. Even if you can't admit it to yourself, perhaps now you realize how crucial you are to our salvation.
We'll be right back. Can't be it.
Holy hellhounds! Those dogs found out for blood.
This can't be it.
Can't be it.
Can't be it.
A dog is quietly curled in the corner of the cage, seemingly trying to make itself as small as possible.
Please, don't hurt me. But I might hurt you. You smell like what they feed me. They changed me. They made me want to hurt people.
A low growl. The dog starts to salivate and lick his chops. His eyes go hard and cold. Suddenly, he seems to remember himself and whines.
They did something to me. They made me want to hurt people. People who smell like you. I don't want to hurt anyone. I'm afraid. If I leave, I might hurt someone. If I stay, they'll make me into one of their monsters. I'm better off dead.
You let me free? What if I'm dangerous? What if I hurt somebody? What if I hurt you? They fed me horrible things. Meat from people. I didn't want to eat it. But they do something to it that makes it irresistible. Even you, the one who saved me, I can picture sinking my teeth into you, ripping the flesh apart, swallowing it down. I'm scared. I'm not myself anymore. I have these cravings. I can't be trusted.
A low growl. The dog starts to salivate and lick his chops. His eyes go hard and cold. Suddenly, he seems to remember himself and whines.
This is awful. I can't go back into the world like this. Please, just put me down. No, no, no! I start again. No one will want me now.
The creature before you stares with sightless eyes and leans from side to side, like a puppet without strings.
What's behind those eyes? A person, I bet.
Haunted look in its eyes. Whatever it was, it's in terrible pain.
Looks like this place has been sealed up for a century or two.
There could be a good reason why no one dared to enter in the meantime.
Here lies Withermore the Sage. Here lies Withermore the Noxious. You sense a great whirl of energy within the jar. From its depths, a faint voice howls. This must be the container that holds Lord Withermore's soul. The jar smashes to smithereens on the floor.
Statue has a strange silhouette.
You notice a deep fissure beneath the statue's right hand. The stone there is a curious color, as though it was added after the statue was carved. A chunk of stone falls from the statue. There's something hidden inside.
Lucky find.